Hi, this is second video on ngSpice. Today we are going to write a ngSpice code for half a rectifier. Circuit is given here. It has three components. One is sinusoidal voltage source, another one is diode, third one is the resistor. So let's start writing the code for this. So I will use nano text editor. Nano, and we will name it as HW or half a rectifier dot CIR. And first line is nothing but a comment. So we will write that ngSpice code for half a rectifier. In this, I have given the syntax for each component. First one is sinusoidal voltage source. Syntax is V name positive node, P means positive node, negative node, and sign, and start value, peak value, and frequency. Let us give name as, it should start with V. Let us give name as V in, name of the voltage source, and positive terminal, that is, you can see in the diagram, it is 1 and the negative is 0. So we'll write 1 space 0, and sinusoidal it is, and starting value let it be 0, and we will take a 60 volt signal we will take, and the frequency let it be 1 kilohertz. So we have defined voltage source. Next one is the diode. For that syntax is given here, it is D name, PN and diode name. So it should start with letter D, and the name you can give 1, D1. And it is in between 1 and 2. Positive is 1, negative terminal is 2. And name of the diode. So I am using a custom diode, that is a diode with custom parameters. I will call it as a my diode, and we have to define this my diode. I will give that later. Next one is the resistor R1. It is in between 2 and 0, and value is 1. Now we will define the model of diode. So the command is, again, syntax is given here, that is dot model diode name, here my diode. You have to write symbol D, and diode parameter we have to write. So for that you have to refer a SPICE manual. For example, for diode, these are the parameters you can define. IS, saturation current, RS, ohmic resistance, like this. These are all the parameters you can define. By default, they will have some value. If you want to change it, you can define it. So I'm in this tutorial, I'm going to use IS and VJ, that is saturation current and junction potential. So dot model diode name, that is my diode, and D. IS, let it be 1 into 10 power minus 60, that we will write 1 minus E16. Okay, so you can see here default value is 1E-14. We are defining it as 1 minus E16. You can see here there is a correction here. It should be 1E-16. So 1E-16 means 10 power minus 16. Then VJ, it's a junction potential. When diode is forward biased, what is the voltage across diode? Typically, a silicon diode, it will have 0.7 voltage. So let us define only these two. One is saturation current, another one is junction potential. Now we will end the code. Yes, this is a code for half-way rectifier. Now we will simulate this, and we will perform the required analysis. We can do that. So first we will save this one. and we will use ngspice command, ngspice and hwr.cir. Now we have loaded the code now. That's why you can see the first line we have given this title, ngspice code for half-way rectifier. So first line it will display, it is a comment, it will display that one. So that means it has loaded that code. So what we have just now we have written, that code it has loaded. Now let us perform the transient analysis, because to observe the output, half-way rectifier output, you need transient analysis. That is, x-axis is nothing but a time. So input is a sinusoidal and output will be during, in this case during positive cycle only diode will pass the signal, negative cycle it will block. So only one half cycle only you will get the output. So for that, again for performing transient analysis, syntax is, you can see here, tran step size final time. So tran step size, so let it be 0.1 millisecond and the total time, final time, since 1 kilohertz I have used, we will use 1 millisecond. So if you press enter, then it will give at what temperature it has calculated, and it is giving warning because we have not given any DC value, because we are using pure sinusoidal signal. So 0 it is assumed, and it has calculated, and it has shown, or it has given branch currents also, okay, node currents. So that is not required now. So what we would like to see, we would like to see the voltage at 1 and 2. Voltage at 1 is the input and voltage at 2 is the output. So we'll see what output it will give. So you can see here the red color, that is the input, complete sinusoidal signal you have here. And blue color, that is output. You can see here only positive cycle output is present, negative cycle output is zero. So if you want to plot only output only, so then you can write a plot V of 2. So you can see here, only during the positive cycle you will get the signal, negative it is clipped. So again you can take a hard copy also here. If you press hard copy, the PDF copy will be available in a particular folder. For example, if I write hard copy, you see the terminal here, the file, it is stored in this temporary file, TMP, and name of the file is HC5145, may be printed for a postscript. So this can be used for printing purpose. Okay, so this is a short tutorial on how to write a code for half-way rectifier. Thank you.